Foundation work is being done, like I'm thinking of the fill on the water side that's gonna be the backfill.
So there's a requirement that the monitor be there at the pre-construction meeting, and to do inspections, periodic inspections, and then to certify that the work has been done.
But the construction has started, so I think there needs to, that was wording I suggested we needed to change at the beginning.
Yeah.
So the environmental monitor needs to be on site immediately after the DDP is granted.
Yeah, so I reworded to say before the start of the work under this permit, to be clear that, because in some sense construction started, but in another sense, it's like the construction that will start as a result of this permit and the building permit.
Okay, but they can decide to be on site during some of the work, like the stuff that's a little bit more sensitive.
Yeah, and so from that sense, that's why we require just to report, them to report to us in writing that the work has been done, and then it's sort of their professional, you know, determination, like what do I need to see in person versus, in order to sort of sign off that the work has been done versus what could I just, you know, come and visit to verify that it's all been removed.
Just a reminder, this is the opportunity for council to add conditions to the.
Yeah, for sure.
And that's why I'm sort of saying, I guess because there's two very sensitive areas that have been identified, I think we should require the monitor to be on site, QEP to be on site when that works.
That's up to him.
Well, is it in there, did he, or, I mean.
I think I put, to participate in the pre-construction meeting and to inspect the work site periodically during construction, so it's not continual monitoring, but it's visits.
Just in reference to that greening up of the retaining wall, because the retaining wall is gonna be very visible from the beach, and it's gotta be, whether you put some rock on the front of it or do something to make it not, just not pure concrete, you green it out, there's all kinds of ways to do that, but are we noted that we want that in the DDP, is everybody in favor, or how does that work?
You would have to make a motion, I think.
Okay.
Well, can we add that as a condition of the DDP?
I mean, the challenge with that is the retaining wall itself isn't a part of the variance permit. I mean, the applicant has noted that that's their intention is to do it.
If we do it as a separate resolution, separate from the DDP. And it would be that council request that staff consider at the time the issuance of the building permit.
As an additional condition of the building permit?
For the wall.
Would work for the wall?
For the wall.
Okay.
Has there been a building permit applied for the wall?
Yes.
I'm thinking about the prior discussions we've had about greening up of other walls in this community and the cost involved in actually doing that. I'm just concerned that the security deposit that's associated with this DVP is insufficient if we have to take on the responsibility for making sure that certain things are done on site.
I think the thing here is that on top of it, you plant something that will fall down over the front of the wall.
Yeah, or build something into the wall, they do that now.
Yeah, well they can't, but I mean that drives out the guys, but if you have a planting on top of a goal, an ivy, Virginia creeper, that sort of thing, but one that's not an invasive species, then whatever that one might be, I would think that that would be the logical way of having the wall read the screen from the water.
Yeah, I'm not so much talking about the nature of the plantings, but just ensuring that there is sufficient funds for us to do work that needs to be done in the event that the proponent doesn't do it.
Daniel, I mean, I know you're not a professional environmental consultant, but do you think the $5,000 is sufficient to cover remedial work if the municipality has to complete?
I mean, this would depend, you know, how much remedial work. I don't know if would it cover. No. Typically, I would think if we have, you know, same with a building permit, we get a deposit so that we could complete stuff, and this gets generally on the public side, but more we use it as the leverage to make the applicant do it.
I think this is something in the order of 30 or 35 foot wall, right? Long, right?
Longer.
Okay, long.
Yeah.
The greening could be as simple as planting things that will grow up at.
Yeah, theoretically. Sir Melanie, that's fine.
So I'm just picking up from the conversation that's happening around the table, it sounds like the
the wall is more the issue than the actual building. So I'm just wondering if the building was required to be behind the setback, would there still be the need for that retaining wall?
Yeah.
Or do we move the whole thing back? So in that case...
I think the building permit has been issued for the wall.
It hasn't been issued, it's been applied for.
But would, if the building was need, was, if we do not issue, if today if we decide not to issue the DVP and the building has to go behind the...
And we have no control over the wall at that point.
But does that remove the need for that wall to be where it is? And does that just naturally pull it back?
No, the wall doesn't need to be there. The wall is there to raise the front to give them a front yard. I mean, it's...
But their front yard would then move back. I think their house was further back.
It'd be bigger.
Daniel, just for clarity, if with the wall being built, is that required within the setbacks?
It can be anywhere on the lot.
So irrespective of where the house is, because they would put the wall within those setbacks.
So we have no requirement to have to require them to take the wall down or anything else. And we have nothing in the bylaws that says walls have to be...
They could have built that wall without the requirement for DVP.
Yep.
But now require that it be green, right?
Yeah, we'll do that by separate council resolution.
Yeah. If that is agreeable to, if that's the little council, yeah. That would be after the DVP or before?
I would suggest pass that resolution first.
Oh, no, I guess it,
Yeah, because if you're against the DVP and you lose and the DVP goes ahead, you want to have input into the wall.
Okay. Sure. I'd like to move the council that issued a variance permit DVP 02-2017 for the variance of setback to the C for 1774 Billington Road, legally described as Strata Lot 5, District Lot 2958. Group 1, New Westminster District Strata Plan, BC, S4476, PID 02-888-3934.
Okay, do I have a seconder? Okay,
seconder. Just one comment. As far as the neighborhood is concerned, they did get consent from John Tennant, who's chair of the Strata. So that was, they had approval there for this.
I'm sorry, just so I understand.
I was just.
As chair, he approved the?
The building there, the location, the variance. Yeah.
Okay, so he had prior knowledge of the location.
Apparently, yeah.
Just
as an aside.
Yeah.
Anybody who lives within the Strata Corporation, before they get a building permit, has to have a letter from the Strata Corporation saying they've satisfied the Strata bylaws. The Strata Council is okay with it.
I would say that we got a letter from the tenants as neighbors that they support the variance request.
Not from the Strata Corporation?
The Strata
as neighbors. Hmm? As the neighbors and owners of Lot 4 that they...
So it was as neighbors, not as...
Yeah,
rather than chair of the Strata.
Yeah.
I don't think we got anything from
the Strata. So there's nothing on the file from the Strata?
Oh, that's interesting.
Well, we wouldn't usually see that, would we?
If there's a Strata involved, they often ask, but unless the Strata bylaws require the Strata Council to approve, then it just depends on what the bylaws say.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's an aside.
When the municipality is going to issue a building permit and the lot is inside the Strata Corporation, does the municipality not, as a matter of course, ask for a letter from the Strata Corporation?
For this building permit, it has a building scheme on it that's controlled by the Strata. So yeah, the Strata, we would seek Strata to sign off on the building permit.
Right. So that will be required before you issue a building permit.
Yeah.
So that will be part of the process going forward.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Yeah.
Let us assume that the Strata did not agree, for example. The Strata has the right to either agree or disagree. Mm-hmm. Let's assume it did not agree. What happens then?
You don't issue a building
permit. If there's a covenant on title, it's a building scheme between the Strata and the property, then we seek the Strata to sign off on the building permit.
But it depends on what the covenant in the building scheme says.
Is it for form of character, do you know, Daniel?
Yeah, to a large extent, yeah.
May I ask respectfully, would it be wise to have this step clarified before we go any further? Just asking the question, would it be wise to have this step clarified?
Don't think it's the next step in the process for the Strata Corporation to make a decision on whether or not to allow the building to go ahead. I think they would want to know that the municipality was willing to issue a variance permit. Otherwise, it's an academic exercise for them. However, once we've done the variance permit, then it goes to the Strata Council with the plans, with the permits in place.
It all depends on what
Strata rules
the covenant, right. The building scheme says. If the building scheme is entirely for form and character, then it doesn't matter what the Strata says. If the building scheme is for location, siting, and form and character, as ours is, then the Strata Council has to sign off on the whole thing. But so it just really depends on what that building scheme says.
But whether we give a DVP or not, right, they don't get a building permit until there's clarity with the Strata Corporation.
Correct.
So there's no real need for us to wait for the Strata Corporation to make their decision. My understanding would be they would fall between the DVP and the building permit.
But I would guess that if the form and character, if the, what is it called?
It's a building scheme.
The building scheme says the Strata Council must approve the siting of the building, then they would have written.
Michael, I can assure you, if there is any issues between the Strata Corporation prior to issuing the building permit, we will get legal counsel. We will involve them. Legal counsel.
Okay, because we cannot reach an impasse. We've got to move beyond an impasse. Mm-hmm. I think I'm trying to, just to ensure fairness to all parties, that these in this quite complicated procedure, made more complicated by the mess up on the process, that the necessary steps are approved. And if we do approve this step, just what it is we are approving.
Okay, so we've got clarity on that. Any other discussion before I call the question? Okay, all in favor of granting the DVP, the recommendation before council? Those in favor? Okay, we have three in favor. Mm-hmm. Okay, and those opposed? We have four opposed. Okay, so the DVP is not granted. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we don't need to talk about any recommendations?
No.
Okay, fair enough. Thank you, Daniel. Okay. So, next up is Kristen.
Council consider giving three readings to the annual tax rate bylaw, which is required for the municipality to levy property owners for 2017. I just wanted to update you on the results of the final completed tax roll, and it was interesting. We started the year with a preliminary tax roll value of $2,070,620,000, and by the time the appeals process had taken place, the tax roll lost about $4 million. It went down to $2,066,878,000. So a little bit lost there.
How many appeals were actually filed, do you think?
I don't know the actual number, but there are still a couple that are at the the property appeal board. They're yet to be decided. Mm-hmm. But again, because we're so heavily single family residential, any one appeal by any property owner wouldn't have any impact of any significance to us. So this bylaw needs to be adopted before May 15th. So the plan is to give it three readings today and three readings on May 8th, and we will be ready to go to share our tax notices.
Three readings and three readings?
Three readings, and did I say three readings again on May 8th? How about just fourth and adoption on May 8th? How about that?
Readings. No. Okay. Any questions for Kristen? Yes.
What was last year's mill rate for general class?
Sorry, I didn't hear what you said.
Last year's municipal tax rate for residential?
2015, the tax rate, 2016 tax rate was 2.55, and it's now dropped to 2.177.
Okay.
Okay. And that gives our an average increase of 2.5%.
Correct.
On the total.
Yep.
Okay. So, does someone have to, or any other questions for Kristen?
I have a question. It's not directly related to this, but in some correspondence I read a while back, there was a mention of the percentage increase that would be necessary to bring in an additional $45,000 or $50,000. Do you recall this, or?
A percentage, like an increase to the tax rate?
Yeah.
Yep, about 1% increase would generate another $45,000. So
it's that large an increase to generate that small
amount?
Yeah,
it is.
Okay.
It is.
Thank you. I just wanted that confirmed.
Yeah,
it sounds a lot worse than what you, on a cost-benefit analysis thing, it sounds awfully bad for the amount of money you get.
Exactly, because we were talking about, you know, looking at the future increases, and when you actually did that whole 1% gave us less than $50,000,
yeah.
I mean, that was...
Yeah.
Right.
It's not a big amount of money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Any further discussion before we get this read?
I just want to thank Kristen for her hard work on this.
Yay.
17 years of working here, and since she's taken over this process, it's amazingly.
Yeah, I've been here for 17 years.
Yeah. But it's not the painful process it used to be.
It's fun.
Yeah.
Fun.
Fun.
It's
over.
She gets it out early. Thank you, Kristen.
Yeah.
How many hours does this take, by the way? This whole process. I mean, I know it's a bit
the
hairy.
The hard part's the budgeting part and getting
okay.
That part. This is just math. This is math.
This is the form that you push.
Okay. Do you want to read this for us?
I don't have it in front of me.
I'll move that bylaw number 435/2017, cited as Bone Island Municipality Annual Tax Rate Bylaw Number 435/2017
be read for second and third time. And do I have a seconder? And any further discussion before I call the question? All in favor? Passed unanimously.
Eight. And are the parcel taxes?
They were on the consent agenda.
They were on the consent.
Yes.
Okay. We have no staff reports. No, or correspondence? Was it 12.13? Was that 100 correspondence?
12.4.
Information.
Yeah,
numbers.
But
okay.
My apologies, that shouldn't have gone under information item. But Sophie received it late Friday afternoon, and I just got a text about it, so I didn't quite aware of what it was. So my apologies for that.
Okay.
Are we going to get copies of it?
So where are we? Are we on section 11? I didn't move from the consent agenda, or are we in the business?
No. I was just clarifying whether I should be talking about anything on the correspondence. So reports of committees dealt with consent agenda. Melanie, anything on the
committees and declaration?
So are we doing,
are we on 10.1?
Section
10.1.
We've removed the items from the consent agenda that we put under number 11.
Oh, 11. Okay, fine. Okay, great. Yes. Well, I hope everybody read there. Okay, so we'll do communities on the move declaration.
Mm-hmm.
I hope everybody read through it and hope everybody's in support. Does anybody have any questions? Fits really well with, I think, where we want to go with our active transportation. It's really about advocating at the upper levels of government to give us more money to be able to do all these wild and great plans. So. Mm-hmm. There we go.
Okay.
So what exactly are we passing? What, there's a motion?
No.
Endorsing?
Yeah, what are we passing?
Oh, we signed the declaration.
There's no...
There's
nothing in the email that has a draft resolution.
How about that the mayor, on behalf of council, be authorized to sign the declaration?
Okay.
They're asking for signing of the declaration.
Yeah. It's on page 102.
Mm-hmm.
And then hope can flesh out what the declaration mm-hmm. actually is.
Mm-hmm. I would move that.
Okay. Seconder?
Yes.
Okay. And all of those in favor?
Yes.
Okay. Any opposed?
good as it didn't need the DBP.
Could we just ask maybe at the staff level, if when it comes to when we have endorsed it, and we go through our regular communication channels, if this could be, if we could tweet about it, because BC Alliance is trying to raise its profile by tweeting, so then we can do that, and we can show that we've endorsed it, because I think they're trying to.
And then we know how to tweet.
We know how to tweet, but we're doing very good on the tweeting.
Yes. Are you offering to help the tweeting remedial group?
I don't want to know, no.
No, this is why we have young staff.
Well, it's okay. That's why the old people that like normal communication.
All it means is we take whatever we put in our newsletter about it, we just copy and paste that into different channels.
Sure.
Yeah.
I think it automatically does that. If you put on Facebook, it's automatically tweeted.
So
I don't know what tweeting.
But just some of our minor things go. This is kind of minor. We normally do it for a big.
The motion we just passed, and I sort of didn't stick my hand up one way or the other, because the links on the agenda package where it says sign the declaration or download here don't work. So I have absolutely no idea, nor would the public, of what the declaration says.
Mm-hmm. We should have that working.
And the community's on the move. If there is a thing that says sign the declaration and download here, but they're not live, they don't work. So I think for the benefit of the general public, they should be added as separate documents to the agenda so people can see what it was that we.
Council Morris, I understand, I think in the attachment you mean from the letter? So it gives the actual link, but because it was an email, it had to be converted to a PDF, but the link.
No, I mean communities on the move, the actual link.
Page 102.
Keep going. That you got the email, and then there's the next document.
Okay, I see.
And then at the very bottom it says download here, so that's the declaration.
Right, I see.
So we don't have the actual declaration in our agenda package.
Gotcha.
Right.
So we voted to approve something that we have.
But it does say in the letter from Ali Fleck, how to endorse communities on the move. We encourage you to show your support for communities on the move. Please visit blah de blah blah.
Yeah, but those links aren't live. They don't work.
The one above it does.
I'm pushing this, nothing happens, and I'm down here and pushing both of these and nothing happens.
It takes about But it takes about 30 seconds to just key it in. The declaration is on the bchealthandliving.ca website, and there's a list of 73 organizations and municipalities.
I'm not disagreeing that all that's
not
there.
Somewhere. Hope and I hear you. And
yeah, I mean, we as a public, think the actual declaration needs to be in the agenda.
Hard copy of the, or electronic copy of the declaration from now
in the agenda.
Of something along those lines, yeah. Absolutely.
Thank you.
Okay. So when we sign this, I just fill out the form. There's somebody just fills out the form and sends it off to them and says we're an endorser.
No, you don't need to include your special signature.
Oh, darn.
I think it's that simple, yes.
Yeah.
We can do that.
Okay. But there's someone has to read it. Did I say that? Okay. So next up, we have, now we've passed that, it's then Metro Vancouver Director, Councillor Nicholson.
So we have two Metro meetings this week. The first one is this Wednesday at Municipal Hall. Be preceded by a walkabout in Davies Orchard. So this is the visit of the Metro Parks Committee and consideration of the two options that are being proposed by Metro staff for the Davies Orchard. And I've sent you a link about them. Members of the community are finding their way to that link and reading through material. It's an open meeting. On Wednesday, so you're welcome to come. There'll be a closed component that deals with other matters. But this is the first time the committee's been here in living memory, as far as I'm aware.
They have been here before, but as part of a conference, a regional parks conference. Okay.
Oh, they were here to approve the golf course in Crippen Park million years ago.
Oh.
And protesters showed up and they voted against putting the golf course in the park.
to that, but that was a meeting of the Metro Arts Committee.
And that would have been in the 80s?
No.
Like the 80s or 90s?
Yeah, it wasn't due to GBRD.
I was in the 80s.
The GBRD first director, yes. A day that will live in infamy.
When is the closed meeting part, if I read the agenda correctly, is at the end?
The closed meeting's always at the end.
Yeah.
What's the time of the meeting?
From about 10 o'clock onwards, they'll be here. From 9 o'clock onwards, they'll be in the orchard.
Okay, so they're coming over on the 8 o'clock, or?
They're coming over on the 8 o'clock.
Okay, so sorry, if we want to do the walkabout with them at the orchard, we should meet them down there.
I don't know if we're actually invited to.
We're not there. They're meeting with us up here after they have done their walkabout.
Well, they're not actually meeting with us. They're not meeting with council.
We're sitting up here.
I see. They are just having their meeting.
We are having our regular Metro Parks meeting, and the committee will be talking about the two options. And then depending on the outcome of this meeting will either be a vote to approve sending the two options forward to the Metro Board to get Metro's okay to do further public consultation, or staff will be given other direction. My expectation is that between Wednesday and the time that the Metro Board looks at the options, that they will try to have a meeting with council. That was what we had talked about with Jeff Fitzpatrick in the past, because I don't think they want to go to the Metro Board without having discussed the options with us as a council and being able to say we were consultative and we have feedback from Bowen Council, et cetera.
Okay, and how many people will be meeting here?
I think there are about 12 members of the committee. And then there'll be the staff contingent.
Wow, is this room going to be big enough for them all?
Sure, 20-ish
people.
Yeah. Okay.
No, it's just the committee. Sorry, just the committee at the table, and then staff in the audience, gotcha. And any members of the public in the audience, including council.
So at the moment, I'm not aware of any confirmed delegations for the.
When do they have to apply for the meeting?
Last week.
So.
So we'll have a sense of what might be done there, and either option represents either the one that keeps four cottages and takes down six has an $800,000 investment in Bowen, and the one that keeps six cottages and takes down four has a $1.3 million investment.
But there's more money in that than just taking down cottages. There's all sorts of other stuff when I went in and read the detail. But taking down the cottages is not
the funds that are
is a very inexpensive.
The funds that are allocated are for park remediation, shifting parking lots, putting in a nature playscape, and so on. So it's the whole package.
Yeah.
Once a plan is adopted, what's the sort of time frame for implementation?
I haven't been told officially. We will probably go through that on Wednesday, but the way that things have worked in the past with larger capital projects like this is that if the plan is approved, so we've gone through this initial step, public consultation, it goes back to the Parks Committee, and then it would come back, I expect, to us again, if there were substantive changes, and then it would go to the Metro Board. So most likely it would come back to the committee in September, and possibly to the board in September, possibly October. And then the capital expenditures would need to be built into the capital budget for 2018. So if it were approved in the early, if something were approved in the early fall, then it's possible some work might be done under this year's capital budget because there were some funds in place, but it's also possible that it might flip over into 2018. But it's not something that's on on a far horizon.
So it'd be imminent, sort of like within the next 5 years?
Oh, not within the next year.
Great.
Very exciting.
I think that would add a lot of excitement to the plan to know that once a plan was finally decided upon, that there would be quick and swift movement.
It's in the park manager's work plan that the decision will be taken in the third quarter of 2017.
Great, that's really exciting.
And then we've got our board meeting on Friday.
And you've got a new park?
Oh yes, and we have a new park. And you would have received information about
it's
that.
In our
yes, it's in here, it's in the package.
So there's a whole bunch of other Metro Vancouver material in there to do with the new park, which Parks is just ecstatic about and a little frightened by, the new Grouse Park, whatever it's going to end up being called. And there's also the homelessness report in your agenda package, and the overall for the region, there's been a 30% increase in homelessness. The North Shore has actually gone down in terms of there are fewer homeless people on the North Shore. This report does not include some of the expanded data collection that they did to cover people who were living in what they call waterways. So it doesn't at this point reflect any liveaboards in any of the region.
Mm-hmm. People doing these surveys, I have some understanding of how very difficult this is, and trying to get numbers on this is really, really hard. When you looked at them, did you feel that the numbers were probably as accurate as we could reasonably expect to get?
Yeah. They worked with a nonprofit organization that has a lot of experience and trust with the homeless community. And the method that they used was not particularly intrusive. So I think given that.
Yeah.
And also the numbers made sense to me, just in terms of where the increases were and what was coming out from those communities, the really big increases in Langley and in Maple Ridge, because that's where a lot of the very high level concerns are coming
from. The court cases and the campgrounds.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Island Stress Report. Yes,
Alan. Well, two things. One is sort of Island Stress, because Island Stress has been dealing with derelict vessels and that kind of thing. But I have pictures of black eyes being towed out of Mandy Bay yesterday.
Yes,
indeed.
So
yes.
I thought that's kudos to all the hard work that Bonnie did. I have no idea what's happening to it after it gets to Richmond, but that's fine. And the other thing is, which I did inquire for, but we've received as Island Trustees a document that was sent to the Island Trust. It's a survey of local government elected officials on responsible conduct. And there was a reference to it in the UBCM newsletter that it would be being sent. So did we not get something sent to either?
No, we didn't.
I don't recall seeing it being forwarded.
I thought it might be in the agenda, but it wasn't. So
yeah, well, it's a survey for us, so I don't think it's anything that would go on the agenda. But I have received it through the Island Trust, but it should have been sent to all either corporate officers or CAOs to be distributed to their councils.
I believe Kristen sent it out while I was on vacation.
Yeah, I got that.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, pretty sure that's what she sent out. We'll double check the staff.
Yeah.
Kristen Watson on March 30th.
Okay, I've got a dilemma. I don't know whether I fill it for in I haven't looked at it, but I just thought, okay, that was, other than that, we haven't had any yet.
I have a couple of things that are in our information items, just so that you can see. It's on page 138. Yes, that's right. It's just relating to the Island Trust response to the changes in the province's approach to private moorage. The province has proposed to make a bunch of changes, including kind of throwing it open not having guidelines there. So, but it doesn't apply to our area.
It applies to the Adams Trust area.
No, but it doesn't apply.
I just wanted to draw people's attention to it, because we are an island within the Adams Trust.
No, but I guess from people's attention, it doesn't apply to Howe Sound and Sunshine Cove. The new rules.
No.
No.
Yeah.
Not yet.
But as a, Islands Trust area, they're trying to make the case that we need special treatment, and that there are, and they're also speaking to rules in the future, so I just thought people would like to know that. And then relating to 12.9, which is the request to endorse World Heritage Site for the Salish Sea, the Islands Trust's response to that is in 1210C, and that just means they endorse it in principle, but can't endorse it completely without having the input of the First Nations first. And so under our new First Nations policy, so that's all. I just wanted to clarify that.
Okay, so that reminded me. We haven't done anything. This was a request, so it's in the information. 12.9 was asking for an action. So should we, as a municipal council, put it as a business item on our next agenda and pass the same resolution that the Islands Trust did?
Yeah. Yes. That would be great. So can we request that? It would be an information, be a
business item. Financial correspondence.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Anything else from our Islands Trustees? Okay, so let's go to item 3.4 of the consent agenda. And that was, and still is, noise exemption Bournemouth Legion.
Yeah, I'll just really make this quick. I just found it interesting on this one that we were also included in our package was like some emails from surrounding neighbors. And it's the first time that I've sort of had any sense of what the neighbors feel about these events. And it just raised a few minor concerns from the neighbors, and I was just wondering if it's possible.